And I'd like to welcome with us today, you all know Supervisor Lisa Bartlett, and it's great to have Lisa back. And today, she's brought along a guest from Soka University, Wendy Harder, and we are going to be talking about a wonderful event that has happened at Soka for many years now. This is the International Festival, and that is coming up on May 4th. So welcome to the both of you. It is it's such a neat event, and you've been part of this for several years now, right?
Yes, this is one of my favorite events every year. So this year it's May 4th at Soka University, and I've sponsored this event for the last 3 years. There is a guest of President Daniel Habuki, mm-hmm. and it's a phenomenal event. It's celebrating the cultural diversity of Orange County. We have food and entertainment and performers. We celebrate Soka's university's birthday, and it's just an amazing event with thousands of people participating.
Yeah, and Wendy, we were talking right beforehand that I didn't realize Soka University has been in this area now for 18 years. And to be honest, I've heard about it many times, but I know so little about it. So this is an opportunity for me and people here in the community to not only have a wonderful event about the festival, but learn about Soka University. If you can give me a little bit of a background on both the university and the festival, because they go hand in hand, don't they?
They do. Well, Soka University is a four-year liberal arts college, and we have an 8-to-1 student-teacher ratio, which means the average class size is 12.
Wow.
And we're small. We have about 450 students on 300 acres, and we're in South Aliso Viejo. And the International Festival is our birthday party. We opened in May 3rd, 2001, so always the first Saturday, right? Saturday of May, that's the birthday party, that's the International Festival. And we started the International Festival because we wanted to invite the community onto campus and also to showcase our students, because 40% of our students are international, and they want to share their culture. And in this opportunity for nonprofit organizations to come in and fundraise and share their cultures. We have 500 performers on 4 stages going all day, and wonderful international food. So it's really a chance to share culture.
Yeah, we're looking at some great photos here. And I've always heard great things about this, because not only do you get to know about the different cultures, but all their foods, and you can see how they're dressed, and they have all kinds of different booths out and vendors, and it's just, it's a wonderful opportunity for people to really kind of travel around the world in just a very small area.
And admission is free.
Yeah.
That's great. But I do want to remind everyone that parking is $10, and we ask people to carpool and have cash to pay, because we can't take credit cards in the parking lot.
That's a good point. Yeah. But for $10, I mean, really, you go in there with several people. What a great event. Now, you've been involved with this for about 3 years.
Yes.
And what's your favorite part of it?
I love the fact that instead of traveling around the world is coming to you in one place.
Yeah.
You get to sample different cuisine from different parts of the world. The entertainment, the performers are fantastic. It's just a great way to spend the day. They have a lot of booths with some where you can shop. Mm-hmm. So I always pick up a lot of knickknacks while I'm there.
Yeah, that part, that both the shopping and the food part sounds like a lot of fun, especially for me, the food. And to be able to go around to these different booths and sample. Is that where they have like basic little samples that you can buy and try their different?
It depends on the exhibitor. For instance, maybe our student Hawaii club made spam musubi.
Yes, which is good. I've had
so you need to have your cash there, because they're not doing credit cards, right? They're little guys. Indonesian satay is doing full plates with the barbecue beef or chicken, the rice. The Vietnamese ladies from the Viet Aid Fund have a full plate that you can choose your fried rice or your chicken or your pork. So there's wonderful opportunities.
Yeah, and you know what I wanted to ask you is it student groups and local community groups throughout Orange County that come in, or it's a mix?
The food is only served by nonprofits.
Okay.
All the profits go to the nonprofit. So if you're buying a $7 kebab, know that you're supporting a local nonprofit organization. So our student groups are nonprofits as part of the university, and that's how they fundraise also.
Yeah. And of course, celebrating just all the different cultures and heritages here in Orange County is wonderful.
Yes, and everything is very reasonably priced.
Yeah, I mean, well, free to get in, and I'm sure the food doesn't cost too much, and you can sample all the different things.
You'd be surprised how many people run out of money. It's the jewelry and the ethnic clothing.
I'm sure they do. Yeah.
And the Turkish ice cream. I mean, there's some things that are just really
Turkish
hard.
Turkish ice cream. I don't think I've ever had that.
And the man has a special tool, and he whirls it around for you. It's a show as well as as something to eat.
Yeah, I'm there. I have to go this year because it's been, like I said, I've never been there, and I didn't realize it's been going all these years, so I have to make a point to get there.
You've got to stop by. And then at 2:00, we also have a cake cutting ceremony to celebrate Soka University's birthday. So that's always special, and we give everyone a piece of cake.
Very nice. And it is really a treasure to have this here in Orange County because it's a very unique university, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, and the fact that you only have 450 students is just surprising to me. I don't think there's an elementary school that has 450 students in South Orange County. They all have probably more than that. But to have that, what an opportunity. You said a lot of the students are from international. How do they find out about it? Is it, I know this is, this started internationally, am I right, somewhere else first, or at least the culture of the university started somewhere else, right?
We are founded by a lay Buddhist organization that is headquartered in Japan. We don't teach Buddhism.
Right.
Our whole curriculum is non-sectarian. We're founded on peace, human rights, and the sanctity of life. Those are our core values. I happen to be Lutheran. Those are my core values, too.
Right.
But it really permeates the university and attracts students who are interested in the mission, which is to foster leaders for peace internationally. So really an incredible group of students, about a 3.9 average coming in.
Wow.
And this year we were ranked in the top 25 national liberal arts colleges by U.S. News at only 18.
Yeah.
So this is a young university, but we're moving up.
And what a great opportunity for people not to just enjoy this festival, but to find out more about Soka University in general. And, you know, for the folks here, I know how much they're going to enjoy it. But maybe you find out something you can pass on to your grandkids, telling them that maybe they haven't heard about this university, they don't live in the area, and let them know about it as maybe an option for them one day. So.
With wonderful scholarship opportunities. We'll get you there if you
can
get admitted.
What a treasure. It really is. So you're going to have a booth there?
Yes, we will have our 5th District County booth there. And Soka University is really a little hidden gem.
It's really
in Aliso Viejo.
Yeah. And again, let's remind people, bring cash. So you have to remember that. And then if you have a way to a carpool there, please do that as well, because I'm sure parking is limited. But what a great time. It's Saturday, May 4th, so it's a couple weeks from now. From 10:30, it's already May almost, gee. From 10:30 to 5. And it's going to be a great time. I'm sure it's going to have a great weather that day. I'll do my best to give a good weather forecast for that. But I really want to go to this because it's something that I've never experienced. And it just seems like a very pleasant place and a lot of fun.
And I think our seniors here in Laguna Woods would really love this event.
Oh, I know they would. Yeah, we have, obviously here we have cultures from all over the world that live here. So what a perfect opportunity. Really great. Good to see you, Lisa, as always.
Good. And I have a few more dates of events coming up.
Oh, yes, please.
Okay. So in addition to the Soka University International Festival on May 4th, May 17th at the same venue at Soka University is our annual Senior Summit.
Ah, that's right. It's going to be over there this year. You're right.
At Soka University, May 17th from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. So new location this year. And of course, as always, we provide breakfast and lunch. And we'll have some fantastic speakers that day geared just towards our seniors.
Yeah, it's a wonderful venue. I haven't been there, but I've seen photos of your performing arts center there, and it's beautiful.
And then on June 5th from 9 to 3 p.m., we're going to have a Laguna Woods County Benefits Enrollment Day. You know, there are a lot of seniors in our community, not just in Laguna Woods, but everywhere, mm-hmm. and they don't always understand or realize some of the benefits that they are eligible for.
Right.
Through the County of Orange.
Yeah, and a lot through the Council on Aging and all, but there's a lot that is available. It's just knowing about them.
Yes, yeah. And so this is a fantastic opportunity where instead of the seniors coming to the county is coming to them.
Yeah.
Right here in Laguna Woods, and we'll have all the information that they need to sign up for various benefits, get enrolled in different programs that we have, whether it's healthcare or, and we're also going to have an on-site complimentary food pantry that day.
Oh, very good.
So we're going to have some new things that they probably haven't seen before. And this is just a great opportunity for our seniors to figure out if they're eligible for certain county programs. This is a great way to match everyone up together.
All right. And that's June 5th?
June 5th.
All right. And I know we'll probably have you on before then
to
remind folks about that. But what a great event. And again, May 4th, Soka University, the International Festival. You can find out more information if you just go online and search Soka University. Click there, and there's information on it. We'll be right back. Thank you very much.
Thank you.